Welcome to my channel Smart Learning Academy. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the solution of GATE 2018 numerical questions. So let's see the solution of questions one by one. This is the first question asked in GATE Biotechnology paper 2018, that the absorbance of solution of tryptophan measured at 280 nanometer in a cuvette of 2 cm path, that is the cuvette length into 2 cm. And the absorbance is 0.56. The molar extension coefficient is given, that is 5600 molar inverse and centimeter inverse. Then they asked for the concentration of tryptophan in micromolar. Okay, so the parameter given in the question, that is lambda wavelength 280 nanometer, cuvette length is 2 cm, absorbance of tryptophan is 0.56 cm, and the extension coefficient is 5600. As you know, Beer-Lambert law, that is absorbance is equal to ECL, epsilon CL. Basically epsilon is extension coefficient, C is the concentration, and L is the path length. Okay, so what is the concentration here? Concentration is absorbance divided by epsilon into L. Absorbance is given 0.56, epsilon is 5600, and length is 2 cm. Just calculate this equation, you will get that the answer 50 micromolar. The next question asked, a single stem cell undergoes 10 asymmetric cell divisions, the number of stem cells at the end. So here is the solution. When the stem cell goes for the symmetric division, that means the daughter cells, two daughter cells, acts like a stem cell. But in the case of asymmetric division, one of the daughter cell goes for the differentiation like other cells, and one of the daughter cells goes for the stem cell function. That represents the stem cells generated after asymmetric division. After every division, one stem cell is generated. You can see here, after every division, one stem cell is generated. That means after 10 asymmetric cells, how much stem cells is generated? That is 10. Okay. After one cell division, one stem cell is generated. Then after 10 asymmetric divisions, 10 stem cells generated. The next question asked in the GATE Biotechnology paper is, the genomic DNA isolated from a bacterium was digested with restriction enzyme that recognizes 6 base pair. Okay, recognition sequence is 6 base pair. Assuming random distribution of bases, the average length in base pair of fragment generated is. Okay, here is the solution. The restriction enzyme recognizes 6 base pair. Okay, so what is the number of base pair available? ATGC, that is 4. 4 bases are available, and restriction enzyme recognizes 6 base pair. Hence, for the first base, probability is 4. For the second, probability is 4 again. And in similar way, probability is 4 for all the bases, all the 6 bases. That means 4 into 4 into 4 into 4 into 4. And this is 4 to power 6. You can calculate this and you will get the answer 4096. Next question is related about the heat sterilization. Moist heat sterilization, that means autoclaving spores at 120 degree centigrade. The equation is given, the kinetic equation is given for the death of the microorganism, which follows the first order kinetics, where n is the number of viable spores, t is the time, kd is the death constant. Okay, KD, the value of KD is given here, and the value of initial number of microorganisms is given here, and the final. Okay, so you have to calculate the time required to reduce this number from 10 to power 10 to 1. Okay, so let's see the solution. So this is the solution of previous question, that is dN by dt is minus KD into N. After integrating this equation, if you integrate this equation, then you will get the result like this, ln n naught by nt equal to kd into t. You can find this derivation in various books of fermentation technology or bioprocess engineering. As I have told you in my previous lectures, that what is the derivation of this equation. Okay, so you will get the formula of time sterilization time t equal to 1 upon kd ln n naught upon nt. Kd is given, n naught is given, and nt is given. Okay, just put these values in that equation and you will get the answer for the t, that is 23 minutes. Here is the next question. An aqueous solution containing 6.8 mg per liter of antibiotic is extracted with amyl acetate. Okay, if the partition coefficient of antibiotic is 170, partition coefficient is Kd, okay, and the ratio of water to solvent is 85, then what is the extraction factor? Okay, so here is the formula, that ratio of extraction factor E, ratio of extraction factor divided by K, ratio of extraction factor and partition coefficient is equal to volume of the solvent and volume of the water. From this formula you can derive this formula, extraction factor equal to partition coefficient into volume of the solvent and volume of the water. This is the formula to calculate the extraction coefficient. Put the values given in the question, that is, here is the partition coefficient. The ratio of volume of water to the solvent is given, that is 85. That means Vw divided by Vs is given. Put this equation, put this value here, and you will get the answer. Extraction factor is 2. The next question is related to the KLa, that is a mass transfer coefficient. Okay, so here in this question, they are given 100 liters stirred fermenter is responsible for the production of secondary metabolite if the specific rate of oxygen uptake, that means specific rate of oxygen, it is the Q, specific rate of oxygen, okay, and the oxygen solubility in broth 8 mg per liter. This is C star. The volumetric mass transfer coefficient KLa is given in second required to achieve maximum cell concentration, that is X max, 12 gram per liter. Here is the KLa. They ask for the KLa. Okay, so what is the formula of KLa? KLa is equal to Q naught into X max upon C star. You can derive this formula from the KLa, from the mass transfer coefficient formula, that where the specific oxygen rate uptake rate is directly proportional to the KLa into Cl star minus Cl. Okay, and here you can put the all values given, and here you can see the specific rate of oxygen uptake given in 0.4 per hour. Okay, so you must convert into seconds, because in the question KLa asked in the seconds. Okay, so here you convert the 0.4 into seconds by multiplying the 60 into 60, and put the values, you will get the answer for the KLa, that is 0.167 per seconds. The next question is related to the chemostat phenomena. In this question, the feed rate and culture volume are given, that is 100 ml per hour and 1.0 liter. Okay, when the glucose as substrate is added, the value of mu max and Ks is given respectively for a glucose concentration 10 gram per liter. Okay, so you know what is the flow rate, 100 ml per hour, that means 0.1 liter per hour. Okay, just 100 ml equal to 0.1 liter, volume is 1 liter, mu max is given, Kx is given, S naught is given, that is 10 gram per liter. At steady state, what is the value of dilution rate? F upon V, flow rate upon volume, and dilution rate is equal to mu. What is the formula of mu? Mu m into S upon Ks plus S. Okay, this is the condition of steady state in chemostat. Okay, so just put the values, flow rate 0.1, volume 1, mu m, and put the values of mu m and Ks, solve this equation, and you will get the answer for the substrate, that is 1 gram per liter. In the next question, they asked, mammalian cells in active growth phase were seeded at a density of 1 into 10 to power 5 cells per ml. After 72 hours, 1 into 10 to power 6 cells per ml were obtained. The population doubling time of the cells in hours is, okay, so what is the solution? The n0, this is initial number of cells, is given 110 to power 5 cells per ml. Nt, after time t, that is 72 hours, the cells number is given 1 into 10 to power 6. Then what is the value of k? that is growth rate constant 1 upon t ln nt upon n naught. Because here is the growth, then nt must be higher and nt must be on upper side. Okay, put the values, t is 72 hours and you will get the answer k is 0.0319 per hour. Okay, what is the doubling time? Doubling time is ln 2 or 0.693 divided by k. It is the growth rate constant. Put the value of growth rate constant here and you will get the doubling time of the cells, mammalian cells, that is 21.7 hours. This question is related to the mass balance. Yeast converts glucose to ethanol and carbon dioxide by glycolysis as per the following equation. Okay, this equation is given. Assuming complete conversion, the amount of ethanol produced in gram from the 200 gram of glucose. Here you can see 1 mole of glucose produced 2 mole of ethanol. That means 180 gram of glucose. What is the amount of glucose in 1 mole? 180 gram. And what is the amount of ethanol in 1 mole of ethanol? That is 46 gram. Okay. So here 180 gram of glucose converts 92 gram of ethanol. So for 200 grams, it is 102.2 gram. The next question is related to the flow rate. And in this question, at the end of batch culture, glucose solution is added at a flow rate. Flow rate is given if the culture volume after 2 hours, that time is given 2 hours, glucose addition is 100 ml. Okay, the volume is given. So what is the initial culture volume? What is the formula of volume at time t? That is V naught initial volume plus flow rate into time. So for initial culture volume, just manipulate this formula and you will get this formula V naught V minus Ft. Put the value of V here, Vf and T, you will get the answer for the V naught initial culture volume is 600 ml. The next question is related to the bioinformatics phenomena. Consider the following alignment of two DNA sequences. Here is the alignment, and assuming an affinity gap scoring scheme for an identity matrix. So you must know the what is identity matrix, okay? And a gap initiation penalty of one, gap initiation penalty is 1 and gap extension penalty is 0.1. then what is the score of alignment? You have to calculate the score of alignment. So let's see the solution of this question. This is the identity matrix for the nucleotide sequences ATGC. 1 is the score for the alignment, for the alignment if the bases are similar, A to A1, T to T1 and G to G1 and C to C1, and rest is 0. If there is no matching, then there is the 0. So what is the sequence given? What is the alignment given? AGT, AAC and AA, there is 2 gap and AC. So what is the score for here? A to A1, G to A0, A to A1, C to C1, and there is the gap. So there is no score is given, but apart from score, there is the penalty, gap penalty. One is open penalty and one is extension penalty. So what is the alignment score? This is the formula to calculate the alignment score for any sequence, that is summation of identity score minus summation of penalty. Okay, so what is the summation of identity score? That is 1 0 1 1 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3, minus summation of penalty, that is G plus NL. G is open penalty or initiation penalty, and N is the number of gap and L is the extension penalty. Okay, so extension penalty is given 0.1 and open penalty is given 1, and what is the number of gap? 1 and 1, that is 2. Put the values here and you will get the value of the alignment score, that is 1.8. okay, so it is this answer of alignment score. The next question is related to the half time. As we have discussed earlier in this solution manual, half life is equal to 0.693, that is ln 2, divided by k. In general term, that is half life of one parameter and divided by half line of second parameter, if you divide this equation for two parameters, you will get this equation, that is k is inversely proportional to the half life. Just put the values given in the question and you will get the answer is 6. This question is related to the restriction enzyme phenomena. Okay, so they asked that the digestion was done by the ECO R1 and HA3. Okay, the digestion is done with ECO R1 and HA3 was purified and used as a template in reaction containing clean out fragment of DNA polymerase, DNTPs and alpha 32 phosphate DATPs. Okay, so as I told you in my restriction enzyme lectures that the autoradiogram only shows the sticky ended fragments, not the blunt ended fragments. Here you can see HAE generates the blunt ended fragments, but EcoR1 generates the sticky ended fragments. Okay, when you cut this vector with EcoR1, that means one here, this fragment must be sticky ended and this fragment must be sticky ended. But this fragment will not be sticky ended because HA3 and HA3 generates the blunt ended, so that this fragment will not be appear in the autoradiogram. Okay, so what is the number of bands will appear in the X-ray film? That is only 2. Okay, so this is the answer for this question. Next question is related to the enzyme inhibition constant. Okay, inhibitor concentration is given, that is I 10 nanomolar. The inhibitor concentration is given in the question. There was no change in the maximum velocity and the slope is increased threefold. That means there is no changes maximum velocity V max and threefold increase the slope. What is the slope of linear Burk plot? That is Km upon V max. V max is unchanged, then the value of Km is increased in threefold manner. Okay, so this represents, this is the competitive inhibitor. This is the competitive inhibitor. If you don't understand that what is the competitive, uncompetitive and non-competitive inhibitor, just learn about the inhibition process. Okay, so this is the competitive inhibitor and in competitive inhibition, what is the formula of Km apparent? Km apparent is Km 1 plus I upon Ki. Okay, put the values of here, what all the values given in the question, Km apparent is threefold of initial Km, that means this ratio must be 3. Okay, and when you put the all values and solve for the Ki, you will get the Ki value is 5 nanomolar. The last question of this paper is, a rod-shaped bacterium has a length of 2 micrometer. This is rod-shaped, that means it is a cylindrical shape. Rod-shaped is a cylindrical shape. Diameter is 1 micrometer and density is the same as water. And if the protein constitute 50% of the cell and the average protein has mass is 50 kilodalton, what is the number of protein in the cell? 1 dalton is 1.6 into 10 to power 14 gram. So okay, so what is the procedure and what is the solution to calculate this equation, to calculate the number of protein for this question? Density is same as the water. Protein is given 50% of cell mass. Protein molecular weight is 50 kilodalton. What is the volume of rod? Rod is look like a cylindrical. Then what is the volume? Pi r square h, or you can say pi d square h divided by 4. Put the values of diameter and height, you will get the volume is 1.56 into 10 to power minus 18 meter cube. You know that 1 meter cube is 1000 liter. Put the value here and you will get 1.57 into 10 to power minus 15 liter. Okay, this is the volume of rod-shaped bacterium. If this is the volume of bacterium, then what is the mass? Because density is the same, then volume is equal to the mass. That means 1.57 liter equal to 1.57 into 10 to the power minus 15 gram. This is the weight of the one rod-shaped bacterium. This is the weight of the one rod-shaped bacterium. Then what is the number of protein? one cell constitutes 50%, this is the 50% of the cell, and this is the weight of one bacterium. What is the weight of one single protein? That is 1.6 into 10, 10 to power 14 gram. This is the weight of 150 kilodalton. Okay, put the values here and you will get the answer 2.94 into 10 to power 6 numbers. Okay, thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.